Oh damn, it's cold. Oh my goodness. This is the Heated Grips episode. Tutorial installation. Let's do that right now. Ah, damn, this, it's actually so hot in this. Get this off. That got super toasty in there. Hang on, let me just, okay, how's that? We're warming up. It's getting a little bit warmer in here. Let's change the temperature of this a little bit. How'd I look? Yeah. Ah, thawing, I'm thawing out. G'day guys, what is up? Welcome to Motorfills. I'm Rob Hamilton. Thank you so much for tuning in and welcome to my new office. This is my new office space. It looks quite similar to my old office space, but I assure you, it is a different space. I literally just moved down like three doors from our last place. So we're stoked. This is like a sick new vibe. So as you guys might be well aware, here in Down Under, it is winter and damn, we are in the thick of it. It's so thick, you can taste it in the morning. Just that fresh, like, ooh, chill vibes. Ooh, and you guys up at North, you're all frothing out, having a great time in the summer. I know, I can see on my Insta and I'm so jealous up until now. Heated Grips, man. Oh, what a game changer. So last week I was like, crap, I'm going on a 3-hour ride down south for a mad shoot. And looking at the weather, I'm seeing -1 degree. I'm seeing like 2 degrees, 5 degrees. And I literally last like 15 minutes in maybe like 12 degrees before my hands are frozen. And once your hands are frozen, it's like you get that chill all through your body. It just gets into you and you just, I hate being cold when I'm riding. I literally get the chills and I just can't stop shaking. You just, my legs are just like uncontrollably. I'm looking at them just going, what the heck, man? What are the legs doing here? And since I rode the Tiger 900, that was my first time using heated grips, and I had a heated seat as well, which is pretty insane. The heated grips thing, I was just like, oh, this is nice. This is a nice little vibe here, keeping my little handies warm. So I thought, stuff it. I walked into Triumph, told Nick, I was like, Nick, please order me in a set of heated grips for my bike. And he did, and they arrived the day before I left. So I just smashed him in there. I'll walk you through it all. I did record it. Not leaving you hanging in the dark here. Alrighty, the details. One of the most asked questions on my IG was, how long's the install time? So they estimate around 48 minutes. I think that's for labor. I think that could be even for just Triumph, the guys that actually know what they're doing. I'd say allow like an hour and a half. I think it took me just a little bit longer, but I was filming as well and stuff. And you know, just taking my time really, which is, yeah, so just allow yourself a bit of time. There's a bit to do, but you can do it. You know, you just have the basic tools and you can nut this out and do it yourself and save yourself some moolah. The cost of these bad boys are $340 Australian. So worth it. If you like your hands being warm, it is well worth the $340. What is in the box when you purchase your heated grip kit? There's actually not much in there, which I actually thought that they missed some stuff. I was like, crap, there's nothing in here. So what is in there? I'll tell you what's in there. You have the sub harness. You have two little rubber strappy boys. You got some screws there. Two are the fixing M4 10 millimeter screws. And the other two are Torx head self tapping screws. Yeah, you got a bit of paper in there. That's just more of a, you know, don't do this, don't do that type of thing. The instructions aren't actually included. That tells you where to download the instructions though. And then you can, look at that. Just download it to your phone, put it in iBooks, and then you've got it there forever. You don't even have to worry about it. But it's a one download for multiple models as well. So you'll see that there's, you know, do this for Thruxenar, do this for Street Twin, do this for Street Scrambler type vibe. So just keep an eye out on those sort of things. It did get me a couple of times. I was just like, I don't have this. What the hell? What the hell, man? What the hell? And then I realized that it was like for the bobber or something. Then of course you got your heated grips and your switch housing, which is already sort of attached to one of the to your grip there anyway. Okay, so just before we head down to the garage and fit these bad boys up, I'm just gonna be reading basically the instructions off my phone, off the instructions that I've downloaded already. The link for these instructions will be also in the description for you to download too, so you don't have to go anywhere and, you know, whatever. So keep your service manual next to you. Only do this if you feel confident in doing it. The part that you need to focus on most or have an understanding of most is that the throttle needs to be free once you've installed the grip, and it has to be locked into its little slots and everything properly, because that's the part that could get you in trouble if you're on the road and just get stuck open or something jams or something. you know, like, need I say more? If you don't feel confident at all, just take it to your Triumph technician. Don't risk it if you're not vibing on it. All right, so first, remove the seat as described in your service manual. Disconnect the battery negative terminal first, and then go ahead and remove the fuel tank as described in your service manual as well. Remove the left and right hand bar end finishes, or in my case, it is the bark busters. Okay, then you want to remove the headlamp bezel fixing and remove the headlamp bezel and lens assembly as described in the service manual. Now, you don't have to remove the headlight completely like what I'm doing here. I only did this because I was moving the gauge from being down low up to the top again because I was doing some sick off-roading. Woo-hoo. You want to remove the headlamp inner cover fixings, retain the screws for reuse. And then you want to disconnect the throttle harness connector from the main harness connector, and that's that big black one there that you can see. Slide the left-hand grip off the handlebar, retain the grip for reuse if the motorcycle is returned to original condition. Mine was a little bit stuck, so I just got some dry lube and just stuck the nozzle in there and gave a little blast and it came straight off, so I was stoked. Remove the plastic insert from the end of the left-hand side of the handlebars as shown. Retain the plastic insert for reuse if the motorcycle is to be returned to its original. So there's heaps of that. Don't throw any of it out because you will probably use it later if you want to take these off and sell them separately or something. Or if you don't like them. I don't know. I don't even know what that is. Just keep it just in case. So then you want to remove the twist grip from the right hand side of the handlebars as described in the service manual. So basically it's just those two screws and the whole thing will just end up sort of sliding off. Now you don't need to run the harness all the way out or anything like that. As long as you can get the grip to slide to the end of the handlebar, then you're sweet because that's just for mounting it back on. You'll see a bit later on. Then thread the sub harness lead with the 4-pin connector into the slot on the underside of the handlebar between the handlebar risers as shown. So now this is what I'm talking about when I say you sort of want to keep your stock handlebars because all these little cutouts and everything are already there for you. So good. And this part here I thought was going to be such a pain. But surprisingly, the lead just went straight in and I was so happy. And then I thought, okay, so now when I go to do the right side, that's going to be a massive pain. But it wasn't. It was like so, first go, straight through. I was so stoked, so happy. Okay, so then on both ends of the handlebars, you're just going to feed the sub harness through those holes there and sort of just give yourself enough length to work with there. Do that on both sides. You're going to connect the sub harness connector to the left hand heated grip electrical connector like so. And there's a little caution here saying a wiring harness which becomes trapped or kinked during installation or general motorcycle operation may result in wiring harness damage and electrical malfunctions. So yeah, just try not to do any of that. Just make sure everything's nice and jiggly and free and just good to move around. It might take you a couple of times to get this right. Just do it right the first time so that you're not messing it up later on. Nice and groovy, just jiggle it till it feels right. You just want it to feel right. And that's where it felt right. And you also want to make sure those wires sort of fit in the slot there in the handlebar itself as well. Okay, then you just want to line up the holes with the holes that are in the bar already pre-drilled there for you. Tighten up those little torque head self-tapper screws and just make sure that button is facing towards you as the rider. Make sure the grip doesn't move and you're all sweet. And then just fit the upper and lower switch housing with the screws supplied. So easy, smash them in there, you're good to go. That button lines up perfectly. Okay, now the right hand side is the 2-pin plug. And you just want to connect that up and pull it through just like you did on the left hand side. And they don't explain this very well, but I think it's in the service manual. I didn't actually have it with me. But when you try to get the throttle back in its slots, you want to have the throttle unit to the end of the bar there. That's why you unplug the throttle itself, so that you can pull the extra length that you need to be able to get the harness right to the end of the bar there. And then you got to line up the holes nicely and make sure that everything moves ever so freely. You need to make sure it's all locked in place, all nice and good together, and that it's not gonna lock, like I mentioned earlier. Because you don't wanna be just going, boom, you're stuck at doing 120 kilometers an hour, bam, into a wall. Seriously though, come on. Do this properly. Make sure it's all nice and free. Make sure you've got everything in there nicely. Make sure everything moves freely. Every single step that you take, pulling it out, locking it in, making sure it moves. Slide it back in again, make sure it moves again. Before you put the housing on, just make sure it moves again. Put it all together. Then I had a little peep with my torch to make sure everything was still free and still moving clearly and freely. Just, you know, triple check again. And then once everything's lined up, you just want to get that housing back over. Lock it all up nicely. Again, just testing that everything's all free and all good and good before I go locking anything up. There, nice. Again, testing, again, right at the end while everything is locked up. I even sat on it just so that I know, you know what it feels like when you're sitting on it and how much restriction there normally is. So I just sat on there just to make sure that it feels just right, which it did, it was fine. And just to recap on what I said, it says here in the instructions, carefully check that the twist grip rotates smoothly through its full range of movement and it's not restricted in any way. If any tightness or resistance is felt, check and rectify the cause before riding the motorcycle. And also ensure the throttle is fully closed and the electrical cable inside the twist grip has adequate slack to allow correct throttle operation. So basically what I said, just make sure it's all damn good and operates normally. Please, please, please. Okay, moving on. And this is where I just plugged up that accelerator cable again and started just putting my headlight back together. Just that's all nice and tidy. Just, you know, reverse procedure, baby. Reverse procedure. And just make sure you're not catching any wiring or anything like that as you're screwing those screws back in. You're just gonna undo that one Torx screw there. And you'll see that it has like a number of connectors on this plate. And it's the most bottom connector you'll see. Disengage the heated grip harness connector, bottom connector, from the mounting bracket and remove the blanking plug from the connector. Route the sub harness across the cable guide and through the frame on the left hand side of the motorcycle. So this is basically what I did there, and then just get one of those little rubber boys and just tighten that up there. That actually suggests to have those blue markings roughly about where I've got them now as well. So if they're around there-ish, yes, sweet. Next, feed the sub harness through the frame to the right hand side of the motorcycle towards the main harness heated grip connector. And then you're just gonna plug that in. That's pretty much it. Then just tighten everything up and reverse procedure. And just when you finish it all, or even before you start putting everything back together, just go lock to lock, full lock to the left, full lock to the right, and make sure that everything's sitting nicely, nothing's pulling anywhere. Give that throttle another couple of flicks. And then you can go ahead and put it all back together and test that bad boy out. Sick, should we take it for a test ride into some cold, cold conditions? Let's do it. So functionality of these bad boys. So it's recommended that you have them on with the bike running, not with just ignition. They turn on with ignition. Because they're a heating element, they can actually, well, they will actually draw a lot of current from your battery, and you don't want your battery to go flat. But they do have a safety, which is sick. So, when the battery voltage drops to 11.8 volts, they automatically turn off. How sick is that? So crank your bike over, hit the button once, it tells you what setting you're on at the moment, which is off, and then you press it again, you got low, you got high, press it again, then you're back off again. So you just got like two settings, or three, including off. So it's off, low, high, and then that's it. Like, that's it. You just let it sit there and cook. So now you can just be like gearing up, you get your helmet, put your helmet on, put your gloves on, man. Yeah, it's freezing cold, it's snowing and everything. And also there's no memory function with this either. So when you turn your bike off or turn the ignition off, it's just going to reset to off again. So you don't have to worry about them just like sneaking on, or like, you know, if you forget them on or whatever. So that's good. All right, let's get the heck out of here, eh? Alright, so they've been on for a couple of minutes now and I'm already feeling them toasting up my hands through the gloves. Now, the cool thing about this is that, like, they keep the exact same stock pattern of the grips themselves. So it doesn't even look like anything's changed, like, whatsoever, apart from just this little button here, which just looks all good and proper, which I'm, like, so stoked about. I thought there was going to be, like, lights or something here. But it's all integrated, all into the cluster. You got no issues. I've been so stoked with them. So I rode 400 kilometers through the Blue Mountains here in New South Wales, and it was like, man, it was probably like 4 to 6 degrees max. It was cold. It was so cold. I still got the chills, but I mean, like, I was riding for like a solid 5 hours, you know. I'm not wearing any winter gloves, like proper winter gloves. What I found was the top of my hands, the top of my fingers got really, really cold still. They helped just maintain the warmth in my hand. Like, it was that cold that sometimes I wasn't even sure if the grips were on. But then you just sort of rotate your hand around a little bit and you can feel that, you know, they're charging, like they're powering through, just trying to keep your hands warm. I can imagine riding without the heated grips, man, my fingers would have been frozen off. I would have been like just done. There's no way I would have been able to do that run. No way. And it's so funny, like, I was against all this stuff, hey. I was like, nah, heated grips, no way, man. They're for losers. These are for losers. I'm sure you guys have seen in my Insta stories and everything.
if you follow my Instagram, check it out, Motorfills. Yeah, like you'd see how much I've been bragging about these things. They've just been one of the best purchases I could have made for winter time, like 100% hands down. So if you're thinking about getting them, just get them, hey. Like, get them, absolutely. They do help. They're a game changer. They literally make your winter riding experience super, super pleasurable. Like, I got no worries. Like, usually through here, I'm just like, winter, nah, no way. It's too cold. You know, you got to rug up. By the time you get home, I'm just like, I've got a chill. I'm sort of shaking a little bit. But now it's like your hands are always free, you know? Like, even pulling the clutch in and all that, you're not tensing up. And that's like another factor that comes into it, is just tensing up while you're riding, because you get cold. And then when you tense up, you can't move, or you're like, you're moving the whole bike with your body, and then that can cause an accident in itself. So if you're gonna do it, do it. I highly recommend it. I give it a mad tick of approval. All right, guys, that is it from me. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you like this video. I hope I helped you. If you had any questions about, you know, the heated grip setup, and if they're worth it or whatever, I hope I answered some of your questions and got you over the line, you know? If you're thinking about doing it, just do it, hey, Please hit like, hit subscribe. I really do appreciate all your support. And I'll catch you guys in next week's vid.